Hey Michael,
Yes.
are you still down the line?
Yeah.
Yes, I was listening to you. Today is a holiday, no, for Quezon City.
Yes.
Okay, so thank you for giving us that traffic and weather update. But I wanted to ask you, Michael, because today on Mind Your Own Business, I'm actually going on solo flight today because Attorney Nikki had to attend to some things. But I wanted
Okay.
to ask you because we're talking about productivity and some tips on how to be more productive at work. Have you ever experienced, down days and ruts, and you just feel like you're just not as productive at work?
Yeah, we do have such down days. I mean,
I think everybody has it, no? It's a natural cycle.
It is,
Even just being tired physically can affect it. But okay, let me ask you, do you have any tips in particular for our listeners that you can share with us? How do you get yourself out of that rut, or how do you make yourself more productive when you find that you're not being as productive as you want to be?
Well, usually the problems that we really get to encounter, I mean, waking up early in the morning, being here at around as early as 5 or 6 in the morning, and then going home at around 8 in the evening, especially in my part, I'm like here the whole time, more than 12 hours actually. I seriously take the power nap. That's the thing.
A
Because
power nap.
my main problem is the lack of sleep, because I only get
Yes.
to sleep around 4 hours every day.
Yes.
So when there is a need for me to actually just doze off for a bit, I do take some 5 minutes off.
Yes, power naps are very important. I'm
Very,
glad
very
you brought
important,
that up,
really.
Michael, because in this day and age, a lot of us are really lacking sleep, and it can really affect us.
And usually I set up an alarm so that I know it's just for 5 minutes or something. And then after taking the power nap, that's when things I get to start working quite well again. And then if ever I do get to hit the slump again, then I give myself another 5 minutes.
Another 5 minutes. I know. I end up giving myself 3 hours, 5 minutes, 5 minutes. Well, thank you for sharing that, Michael. See, that's a very good insight, a very good tip, very good recommendation.
Thank you.
And I know a lot of us have to work for more than 12 hours these days, but there will be a point when, we'll be able to work less and perhaps earn more. We put in our dues. Thank you for always, for being such a great, happy person, bringing us the traffic and weather updates continuously.
You're
Well, we
welcome.
hope to talk to you again. Take care,
Okay,
Michael.
thank you.
Okay, bye. All right, we had a conversation with Michael of traffic.com, and you heard his tip: take power naps, especially if you have the type of job wherein you have a lack of sleep. We have a caller on the line, actually, Brother Francis of Quezon City. Let's put him on. Hello?
Nicole,
Hi, good morning, Brother Francis. How are you today?
blessed day to all of you.
Thank you, thank you.
Thank you very much. I hope you're good too.
Yes, I'm okay. I'm actually very productive today.
Oh, that's good.
Well,
And because,
a little bit of multitasking, but that happens.
well, since Attorney De Vega is not around, we have you all to ourselves.
Oh, okay. Well, do you have any comments, Brother Francis,
Oh,
or any
definitely.
tips? Okay, go ahead.
Well, get organized. Well, the only way for me, I mean, speaking of experience, since a long time ago, since I had the military background,
Wow, you have a
usually.
military background, so you
Yeah.
are really disciplined then.
Maybe.
Maybe.
I couldn't really say that, but we were,
Okay.
one thing nice about the military lifestyle is the routine.
Yes.
You have everything in place, the
Mm-hmm.
time, things, material, men, or organized. It's not really all the combat duty. No. It's more of what I wanted was to get that organization in time, material, and men management properly. So I'm using it now in my civilian life ever since. For me, the only way to get things, the priorities done, no? Because you have to have priorities
Yes, you do.
again. And the only way to get the priorities done is to sacrifice
Sacrifice?
other things.
Yes, that's true, Brother Francis. Because when you choose your priorities, when you prioritize, you make choices. It's inevitable. One comes before the other. Now, what do you tend to sacrifice, Brother Francis? In case they think that you're, like crucifying yourself or
Well,
something.
socialization,
Yes.
and shopping, and going around, and maybe watching television. That's the
Yes.
reason why I actually don't watch television anymore. I listen to the radio because you can do things.
Actually, that's true now, Brother Francis. When you listen to the radio, you can It's also a physical thing. Like, you can do things with your hands, you can concentrate, you can tune out a little bit. But when you're watching TV, you're really kind of sucked into it, no? Your vision and your hearing, that's right. And you have to be in front of it, of the television set. Okay.
Now, with this word sacrifice, okay. I've been dealing with it, trying to wrestle with it for several years, no?
Okay.
I have this word sacrifice all over the place, the sign, even in my cell phone, in my desk. And it's kind of hard, but you have to come out with an idea, why do you have to sacrifice?
Okay.
So I put there, you have to sacrifice the good, you have to sacrifice, that is, dropping, letting go, or canceling the good things, the bad things, the good things, in order to get the better things done.
Yes.
And you have to sacrifice, in other words, drop, let go, or cancel the better things, in order to get the best things done.
Okay, so it even comes in tiers. Drop even the good things to get the better things, and then sacrifice the better things to get the best things.
If you're conscious about that, no. I mean, because you sometimes you unconsciously think you're sacrificing the bad things. No. It's a good thing, but you walk after the better thing. If you have that kind of thinking, then it's easy to sacrifice.
Actually, that's true, no, Brother Francis. Because, for example, okay, some of the tips are like, some of the things I was thinking about earlier were like, when you go to work, you have good relationships, let's say, with your colleagues, but maybe you spend too much time chit-chatting, you know, or texting, or going Facebook, or you socialize a little too much. You also mentioned earlier socializing. Now, it's great to have a network and to be a complete human being and foster friendships, but at the same time, you know, we can't always, let's say, go out and spend 2 or 3 hours with them, or, you know, go drinking or have long dinners and spend a lot, because you're not totally giving up your friendship with them or your network, but you're sacrificing that for something better.
Yes, yes.
And then when you have that, and then as you said, it goes up even more in steps. What's an example of something better and sacrificing it for the best thing? Let's say, what example, do you have any example in mind? Cause,
for example, so that you would really know what I sacrificed, I have to be honest about
yes,
it.
Yes, please go ahead.
I have sacrificed alumni homecomings.
Yes.
Both in elementary, high school, and college.
Yeah.
And even in work, work alumni, like in the armed forces, no?
Yes.
They called me, but I had to turn them down. Secondly, I sacrifice even going to weddings, baptisms, and birthdays. And when some people come knock on the door without prior notice, I tell my wife that I'm not in. Tell them I'm not in.
Because you're busy, you have to get things done and be productive. Because at the end of the day, the thing that you're sacrificing, I mean, these are all good things that you're sacrificing,
yeah,
as you're saying.
Definitely.
And of course, you want to spend time with all these people, enjoy yourself, have them enjoy your company, but you're also working for the good of your family, for security.
For yourself, for your health,
to get things done and to make a contribution to society.
Like Michael, he's a reporter.
Yes, Michael of traffic.com, yes.
Well, he should sacrifice some things in order to put some sleep into his body.
Yes.
Well, the best thing to do, maybe tell his wife or maybe delegation is another thing, which you would mention later, I guess, no? Anyway,
yes,
I want to stick to this organizing thing by sacrifice. That's
sure.
That's all I want to say.
Brother Francis, you just revealed something about yourself. You said before that you're not married. Then now you said you have a wife.
No, I have no children.
Ah, okay.
You can be married, but children is a different thing.
That's true, okay.
That's all. Thank you very much,
okay,
Nicole.
Thank you very much, Brother Francis.
Okay, bye-bye.
Okay, it was great to hear from Brother Francis. That's a fantastic point that he made. I have never actually heard anyone put it quite that way before. Because some people talk about prioritization and prioritizing things and sacrificing. And then, you know, a lot of times, really, honestly, when you hear about, okay, you have to prioritize and choose what your priorities are, your goals, there's a little feeling or voice of rebellion in a lot of us, because we actually know of course, the first thing is, yeah, okay, we'll sacrifice the bad things. But as Brother Francis pointed out, you also have to sacrifice the good things. And it's not bad to sacrifice the good things in order to get better things. And then when you have those better things, it's not bad to sacrifice the better things in order to get the best things in life. Anyway, that was a very good point he made. Organize yourself by making sacrifices, and it's a new idea, actually. It's a different take on the notion of sacrifice. Thank you for that contribution, Brother Francis. It's time for a short break. We're going to do the VOA news, and we'll be back right after this. Stay tuned to Mind Your Own Business on DZRJ 810 AM, The Voice of the Philippines.
Hey, can you please mind your own business?